Hello students, welcome to lecture number 18. Topic for today's session is assembly line production. I Dr. Rohan Prabhakar Dahivale welcome you all. This is online lecture series for the subject operations and supply chain management. Lecture number 18, don't forget to like and subscribe. Learning objectives for today's sessions are to know the basic concepts of assembly line production and to understand the merits and demerits of assembly line production. Assembly line production, we will start with the concept. An assembly line is a manufacturing functional, that is most of the time called a progressive assembly, in which parts, that means usually interchangeable parts, are added as the semi-finished assembly moves from workstation to workstation, where the parts are added in sequence until the finished assembly is produced. By mechanically moving the parts to the assembly work and moving the semi-finished assembly from workstation to workstation, a finished product can be assembled faster and with less labor than by having workers carry parts to a station or stationary piece for assembly. Assembly lines are common methods of assembling complex items such as automobiles and other transportation equipments, household appliances, and electronic goods. Assembly lines are designed for sequential organization of workers, tools or machines, and parts. The motion of worker is minimized to the extent possible. All parts or assemblies are handled either by conveyor or motorized vehicles such as fork, lift, or gravity with no manual trucking. Heavy lifting is done by machines such as overhead cranes or forklifts. Each worker typically performs one simple operation. According to Henry Ford, the principles of assembly are like this. Number one, place the tools and men in the sequence of operation so that each component part shall travel the least possible distance while in the functioning of the finishing. Number two, use work sites or some other form of carrier so that when a workman completes his operation, he drops the part away in the same place, which place must always be most convenient place to his hand. And if possible, have gravity carriers the part to the extent next workman for his own. Number three, use sliding assembly lines by which the parts to be assembled are delivered at convenient distances. Key benefits of assembly line production: identical production of products and greater precision of work, quick and easy assembly throughout the process, maintenance and replacement of worn or broken part is much simpler task. With standardization, interchangeable parts being a key part of the assembly line process. We will continue with the benefits of assembly line production. Generally speaking, assembly line production requires each person involved to only perform a small number of simple and specific operations. For operations or labors, training requirements are not very demanding, and nearly anybody can fill a spot on the production line in many cases. This allows companies to keep expenses low and easily replace employees who leave. Now we will see key disadvantages of assembly line production. Initial capital investment is the key disadvantage, along with repetitive and monotonous work, which is disadvantages for the labors. Summary of traditional production system. So up till now, in my previous videos, we have seen job shop production, batch production, mass production. Mass production, workers place assembly and equipment place assembly. Also, we have seen continuous production. As far as product volume, layout and flows are concerned, now we will compare each and every system. In case of job shop, products are very much products. Volume, one or few of each. Layout is generally functional layout and flow is extremely varied. In case of batch production, there are many products at a time with low or medium volume. And here for production, combination of functional and cellular layouts are used and the flow varied with patterns. In case of mass production where worker pace assemblies are there, products are several to many. Volume is medium volume. Layout is generally a line layout and flow is mostly regular, paced by the operators. In case of mass production, where equipment paced assembly, products are several products, volume is typically high. Layout for production is line layout, flow is regular and paced by equipment. In case of continuous production, the products are one or very few products. Volume is very high. Layout here also is generally line layout and flow is rigid continuous. So this was the summary of traditional production system. For each and every system in detail, like job shop, batch production, mass production and continuous production, you can refer my previous videos for more detail. This is the book of Simba publication, you can refer. In my next video, we will learn continuous flow production. Learning outcomes from today's session, we have learned the basic concepts of assembly line production. We have seen merits and demerits of assembly line production. Don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe and turn on the bell icon for further notifications. Thanks for watching this video. Keep learning, keep thinking. These are some references I have used to prepare this video.